guys, what's up? This is Splice the Movie Fan, and welcome to another summer project. Since this is the summer, I decided, why not review a Simpsons episode that takes place during the summer? There are surprisingly a shit ton of those. The episode I will be reviewing today is Summer of 4-3-2. So without further ado, let's begin. The episode begins with Milhouse saying some nonsense which Bart rightfully calls him out for.
I'm glad the rest of you remembered that summer vacation starts at the end of the day, not the beginning.
I must admit, Milhouse's stupidity here makes me laugh. I mean, who the hell would think that the summer vacation starts by the beginning of the fucking day?
And so, as Abraham Lincoln sat in Ford's Theater that night, John Wilkes Booth entered, drew his gun, and... Well, that's it. Have a nice summer, everyone.
But what happened in Ford's Theater? Was President Lincoln okay?
He was fine. Go home, Ralph.
I absolutely fucking love how Ralph sits there, despite the fact that school is over. It's almost like he has nothing usual to do at home, and is sitting there because he has nothing else to do. And honestly, I think that's exactly the fucking case. The scene is still funny as all hell. In a later scene, nobody signs Lisa's yearbook. And I'm not gonna lie, that is very fucking sad. It really does suck that she has no friends in school. But for some reason, fucking everybody signs Bart. Or at the very least, lets him sign their books. Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, that is a bit messed up.
I don't get it. Straight A's, perfect attendance, bathroom timer? I should be the most popular girl in school.
Yeah, this is something that has been puzzling me for years. It makes no sense to me either that Lisa is the most popular girl in school. I mean, most smart people such as Albert Einstein are fucking idolized as hell. For years, I've been trying to figure out the logic behind nobody in school liking Lisa. And I still don't fucking get it, no matter how hard I try. I mean, I'm sure that there is some logic behind it, but I don't know what it is yet. Now, Flanders offers Homer to stay at his summer house for the summer, which is fucking awesome. Yeah, I will never stop being puzzled by the fact that Homer hates Flanders. He has a very fucking generous neighbor, a neighbor that most people can't even dream of. I can never understand why Homer hates Flanders. And then at the dinner table, the Simpsons talk about going to that fucking summer house.
Mom, why don't I have any friends?
We have each other! When I was a lonely little girl, I always dreamed that someday my daughter would be my best friend.
We are best friends, Mom, but I'm a kid. I need friends my own age, too.
I must admit, that is a very charming scene. Bart cares about Lisa a lot and doesn't want to see her sad, so she tries to cheer her up. Also, speaking of sad, isn't it sad that Lisa's only true friend is her fucking mother? Yeah, it sure is. Lisa should have friends her own age too, like she said. And then Milhouse is tied up tight in the car. Okay, I know he is a bit of an idiot, but this is pushing it a bit.
Wave bye-bye to our house, Maggie. Bye-bye, tree.
Bye-bye, job.
Bye-bye, toothbrush.
Bye-bye, Lisa Simpson.
I really don't understand why this cliché is even a thing in the first place. I commonly see in movies, as well as some TV shows, people driving away from a city due to a summer vacation or some shit like that, saying goodbye to everything in the car. I mean, who the hell in real life does that? It just seems weird to me. I've been on summer vacation with my family many times, including when I was a kid. And not once have I ever said that. Hell, I don't even know anyone who did. So, what the hell is up with this? It's just weird. Though I must say, how Lisa Simpson says goodbye, Lisa Simpson is fucking awesome, as it's great foreshadowing to her future plans in the episode.
When the hell are we gonna get to? Where the hell are we going?
It's called Little Pogmatasquamset Port. It's known as America's Scrat Basket.
So Marge is not complaining about the swearing. That's weird, since she usually does that. As it turns out, in the summer house, There are notes on fucking everything, informing the Simpsons what each item is used for. Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, that is fucking stupid. It's like Flanders is treating them like fucking idiots. Now that actually would be a valid reason to hate Flanders. But does this bother Homer? Nope. Because as always, he has an illegitimate reason to hate him. And then Bart steals Barney from the Pinky Bank. Yeah, this is the Bart Simpson I know and love.
Say, why don't you put on your swimsuit and head for the beach?
Well, it's kind of funny. With all the craziness and confusion and mishigas of packing, I forgot to pack!
Lisa, that's not at all like you.
Exactly.
I fucking love how she puts it so bluntly. And then Lisa puts on new clothes with Marge sport. And wow, she looks so... I don't know what the hell word to use here. I'm honestly speechless when it comes to my opinion on her new outfit. And then Bart and Milhouse jump into the water. But as it turns out, the water is very shallow. I don't understand this. They're at a fucking beach. Surely the water must be much deeper than this, right? And then Lisa finds a fucking library, but refuses to go in there. Says she wants to be different from how she usually is. And then Lisa imagines a lot of fictional characters who start talking to her. I must admit, she has one hell of a wild imagination.
So he goes like...
I can totally hear him going that.
Only kids are that incoherent!
Oh, you'd be surprised by how many adults are complete fucking morons. And then Lisa Simpson makes new friends. They are interesting characters, but my only real problem with them is that they are extremely forgettable. Which, to be fair, is fine. They are just one-time characters. But they are cool since they are Lisa's friends, which means that she did make friends here, which is beyond fucking awesome. And Lisa Simpson advises her new friends where they can go to a place to skateboard which is deserted as fuck. And that place is the public library. Okay, I totally understand a library being deserted now in 2020. Just most people use the internet to get information. But this episode was released in the 1990s. Not even fucking close to everyone used the internet for information back then. So why the hell is that library deserted? It makes no sense to me. It should, by all rights, be very fucking crowded.
Hey, Bart! Lisa's skateboarding with some cool kids! And she looks like Blossom!
What the hell do you mean by Blossom? I decided to look Blossom up, and one of the first results I found are the Powerpuff Girls. But here's the thing. This episode was released at least a year before the first episode of the Powerpuff Girls. The original show, I mean. So it can't be referring to the Powerpuff Girls character. Then what the hell else could they be referring to? I'm confused. And then Bart tries to impress Lisa's new friends, and they are not impressed at all. Well, to be fair, Bart heard it coming, since he was trying to take away from the very few friends that Lisa actually has. Now, while playing a board game, Bart finds it boring, because he focuses his mind more on something that's frankly none of his fucking business. Now, Homer goes to a grocery store, and the guy working there looks a lot like Apu. Weird, Homer is very fucking far from home, and still meets up with a cashier that looks a lot like Apu, which is a very good friend of Homer. That is a funny coincidence. And wow, the guy that works there has a lot of fucking fireworks. I must admit, that is beyond fucking awesome. Later on, Homer uses the fireworks he bought to blow up the dishwasher. You know what I absolutely fucking love about this scene? The fact that it isn't brought up or referenced once for the rest of the episode.
Oh, this is the worst 4th of July ever. I hate America. Come on, Milhouse, let's go down there.
I don't think you should. Let Lisa be alone with her new friends.
They're my friends, rightfully. She only got them by copying me.
Don't have a cow, man.
See? That's my expression.
No, you haven't said that in 4 years.
I hate to say it, but she is right. Absolutely right. Not just about the fact that you haven't said this in fucking years, but also about the fact that you shouldn't be concerned about the fact that Lisa has friends. It's none of your fucking business, asshole. She doesn't have any friends at home. And everybody deserves to have some fucking friends. So just leave it be and mind your own business. You are a massive asshole for caring so much about this.
Bart! I need my glasses! Oh, nice doggy.
I must admit, this is very fucking funny. I love it, but Milhouse is being dumb. It makes me laugh every time. And on the plus side, it did him no harm. So I'm sure that creature is harmless. Unless he actually does harm him off screen. Oh boy, he probably fucking does. It's painful to even imagine what the hell that thing will do to him. And then Bart exposes the truth about Lisa. Alright Bart, I am not gonna sugarcoat this. This is flat out fucking disgusting and you should be ashamed of yourself. Why the hell do you even care that she has friends? You shouldn't be concerned about that in the slightest, since it's none of your fucking business. The fact that you are trying to take away the very few friends that Lisa actually has makes you a massive scumbag. There is no way of sugarcoating it.
Hey, Lise. I guess my little yearbook stunt was pretty rough, but it did teach you a lesson. It's important to be yourself.
I know exactly who I am. I am the sister of a rotten, jealous, mean little sneak. You cost me my only friends. You ruined my life.
Well said, Lisa. You know, you're absolutely right. You got it all spot on. I'm glad you're calling out on this bullshit. And then the next day, the Simpsons go to a carnival.
Remember, kids, there's no need to bump. Just enjoy the ride.
I have to admit something. Marge's stupidity really does make me fucking laugh. I mean, seriously, Marge, they're called bummer cars for a reason. What the hell else do you think they are for? And then Bart and Lisa hide each other in bummer cars. And then Bart feels guilt for what he did. I'm sorry, but it's far too late to feel guilt for that now, asshole. You should have done it much sooner. But as it turns out, those friends that she made still fucking like her and even decorated Homer's fucking car. Wow, man, Bart's plan backfired and it is satisfying as hell. And you know what's also fucking awesome? Her new friends sang her yearbook. That is so fucking great. And Milhouse also signs the book, which is fucking awesome. And I fucking love how the episode ends with a crab, or whatever the hell this is, getting out of a shell and using a fucking kid as a shell. That is so fucking awesome, man! Now it's time for my overall thoughts. I'm gonna have to be honest, this episode is far from a classic. I mean, it's good, but it's unfortunately far from great. My biggest issue with the episode is that the characters being introduced are extremely fucking bland and forgettable. I mean, seriously, I can't name one personality trait of any of them. And that really is a problem. It is nice that Lisa got some friends, but in the long run, this is a good episode, but sadly, one of the most forgettable ones. And the fact that a Simpsons episode between season 1 and 8 is forgettable is one hell of an accomplishment. Because the first 8 seasons are full of very memorable episodes. Either for being good or bad. There are very few episodes from those seasons that are forgettable. That really shows how fucking great those seasons are overall. Honestly, if I wanted to watch a Simpsons episode during the summertime in order to celebrate the summer, I would go with Bart vs. Australia. Now that episode is a golden masterpiece. So yeah, overall, I'm giving this episode the rating 1 thumb up. You have reached the end of the video. Thank you for watching and have a great day.